Hiya folks, this is a very brief tutorial on loading animation files onto your Biped character. Oh god, what have I done now? So if you haven't got the animation files, if they're not in your Max directory, then all you do is you go onto the internet and go to this page here. The link is on my website. So this is the page you want, and I'll quickly show you the link on my website. And also you can find the link to my website on my channel. Come on. Right, and then go on the About page. These animations work in all versions of Max, even that I've got 2011 and it's working in this. So this link here, the very bottom one, click on that and that takes you directly to here. So download this zip file, and then once you've done that, in your downloads directory will be the zip file. That one there, and then go extract to 3ds Max 2010 sample animations or sample BIP files. Extract all that and then place that in your, the next place to put it is in your animation folder. Right, open samples, scenes, biped, actually this motion, BIP, hey, there we go, these are all the animations here. So all you do is you get hold of that, just go, don't use the original source. Oh, actually you can do, because you've got the zipped up version as well. So go cut and then go documents, 3ds Max, scene assets, animations, and plonk them in here. What I'll do is I'll put them in a new folder, 2010 stock animations, so they don't get confused with all my other stuff, and then go paste. Oh, I wonder what was going on then. So there's all the stock animations from Autodesk. And then what we do is go back into Max now, go Systems. So if you've just started Max up, let's do a refresh. Oh, what is going on with this bloody thing? I'm frozen out at the moment. Right, go Reset. Yes. Oh, I'm still on Systems here. Yeah, I don't know what is occurring here. Max is dying on me. Let's shut down UDK. Right, so I've got a reset now. This is a fresh interface with nothing done. So you go Systems over here, this little very corner button. Go Biped. Draw up a biped. And then go Motion. And this first little box that says Biped here, go load file, and see, there you are in your animations. And so let's find that stock one, there we go. Go archers, come on, and then go like that, and there you go. So you've zoom out, and there we are, it's that simple, and then go play. So that's it. I'm not going to go through this anymore. This is just showing you how to load animation onto Biped. And what you can also do is if you want to do motion flow now, you go motion flow, show graph, that little box there, create multiple clips, this second button along here, and then go back into that directory again, stock animations, Red Eye Studios, Archers, select a few of them, go open, and then go define script, that little button here, and then select all of them. Shut the graph down, and then also over here, to create an animation file from that now, we can go either save file as motion flow, or just create a bit file out of it. Now notice there's 1044 frames now. So this is motion flow at the moment. And it's running through all these little animations in the script box. Now notice there's no keyframes on the timeline at the moment. Right, so he's been shot, now he's dead. And now he's come back alive, he's dead again. Obviously you wouldn't create a file like that, but this is just for demonstration right now. Select all these in the script box, go like that. Then this little box here, create unified motion, press that. And go OK. If you've got a slow computer, this might take a little while. See, mine's already done that now. Now turn off motion flow. There you go. You've got now got a new file, a bit file, and then you can save that. Go save as, and we call it Archer_various. And then it's in that new, that 2010 directory, so we just go save. Then we go reset. Scene has been below, I don't want to save it, because you've already saved a bit file, so you don't have to save the scene. Then go zoom out. Now that you've got that animation file, you can load that onto any character that has a biped in it. So I'll quickly show you what I mean by that. Let's find a character. I've got loads of bipeds in. Characters. Biped scenes. And I don't like these ones. No, don't like him. Let's put some of my own bipeds in. There you go, there's one with a biped, I think. Come on. No, it's not. Oh, bloody hell. No, so... Ah, this one's got a biped. Yeah. There you go, there's the biped body there. Just click on the bone and then go motion, load animation, and don't forget under the biped box here, and then we go Archer Various, open, give it a few seconds to boot up, and there you go. Simple. But then we can also, we can add that animation onto a biped, a standard one. Go create systems biped. Oh, I'm in the wrong window here. That window there. And then with him selected, go motion, load file, Archer Various. And he will also be doing the same thing as the character now in the same spot. So let's move him so he's not directly on top of us. So with that biped still selected and not my character, you just go move all mode. Yeah.
Basically, it's just I've come out of Africa.
Yeah.
Where I was getting fucking shot and killed for asylum in Russia. So the Russians have stuck them in a little fucking ghetto. They've started fucking being abused and beaten up and all that lot. So the fucking film crew's gone in there and asked this Russian, what's going on? He says, we don't want black blood in white blood. We don't want it mixed. You've seen the troubles it's caused in Europe and that lot. People want to stay pure. This is one of the fucking top Russians.
God.
Because I was asking, why are you beating them up? We want them to stay where they are. We don't want them out in their fucking city getting white people black.
Mad, isn't it?
But it's fucking unbelievable the way he just came out of it.
Yeah. I'll see you in a bit. Right, yeah, so I don't know if you noticed that there. I was moving, going into move mode. I got temporarily interrupted there. And then after you've moved, you press this collapse button. So with the biped now, what we can do is if we change the timeline and go, say this had that to 1500, and all we've got selected is the biped at the moment. Select all his frames, grab all the keyframes, and then move them to there. Take move all mode out, and now what will happen when we play the animation now, that animation will be offset with my one. Let's unselect it one moment. Because one biped selected like that, it looks ugly. See, so I'm already firing. And in a few seconds, the biped will kick in and start doing his stuff as well. Because his keyframes are further down the timeline. There you go. So it gives the illusion of them being doing different things rather than the exact same animation. I'm dead, I get up again, and I fall down again, and then he'll do the same at about here. So anyway, that's all you need to see, because I'm not going to, that's motion flow itself, converted to biped, to BIP. But to create motion flow, it's a little bit more complicated. But if you look, I've got tutorials on my channel for that, just go through and watch them all. All the biped related ones. So there you go. I'll see you again soon.